Okay, welcome back to the AnyPersent tutorial for this game. Last time we left off at the bottom of this pole after killing ourselves and reloading, so the next area is loaded. Now to proceed, there are two possibilities. There's one zip you can do, which doesn't save that much time, or you can do the casual way, which simply consists of walking to this very cupboard and moving it, and afterwards going through. With the zip, you end up at that button, so I will cut this method recording here. For the zip, you do a wall run and jump off there. Wait a bit, so don't zip previous actions. Roll with a bit of overstepping. The roll here, as you see, has to be fast rewinded. And you should land here. The next area is loaded by going to the sand cloud, as you saw. And that's all there is to this zip. If the enemies teleport in front of you while doing the roll, I'd advise to stop the zip and go the casual way. In general, the zip doesn't save too much time. It's maybe 5 seconds. So as a beginner, I wouldn't do, simply because of the enemies that can screw you up here. So in this area, next up is the palace defense zip. The setup for this is really easy. You hang off this ledge, go up, you center your camera. The inputs are dagger, parry, parry. Steps, steps forward. The actions of the palace defense zip are slow rewinded. And zip then should look like this. At the end of the dagger, you hit the trigger and you end up here. You maybe noticed that while I did the steps forwards, I triggered a camera change. You have to trigger that camera change or else the game will crash, as you can see here. Here with the steps backwards, no camera change is triggered. And if you hit that loading trigger in the dagger, the game crashes. Okay, after you successfully did the zip, you end up here, you roll up or wall run up the stairs. That's just a little movement I won't explain further because it's kind of self-explanatory. Also, because of the zip, the traps are loaded collision-wise, but not really. So be sure to not wall run here, but simply walk around them. Then after you got up here, there are two ways to proceed. There's a little wall run you can do. This looks quite easy, but for this wall run, you have to be really close to the edge there. If you're too far away from it and you do the wall run, the prince will grab the upper ledge. That's what tells you that you were too far backwards. If you have problems with that wall run, that's not a problem because the second method, which is simply jumping down diagonally, because you can wall run up at the end, that's where you want to end up. That method is maybe two seconds slow, so there's not that much of a difference. Okay, next zip is the zip into courtyard. For the position setup, you jump to this ledge, you get up, nothing more. For the camera, you want to aim until the right side of the screen is lined up with the corner there, as you saw. Then you go into landscape. The advantage of that is you see the camera changing as you jump, so you know when to end the zip. The actions are jump, dagger, dagger, sword, reset the camera, walk steps, steps forwards, and then backwards. Be sure to do exactly that step pattern because overstepping or fully scrolling forwards can mess up your zip in multiple ways. It's all fast rewinded. You end the zip when the camera fully stops moving. The aim here is important because in this zip you hit one trigger, and if done correctly, you should land on the sand cloud, and by mashing E on keyboard, you immediately pick up the sand cloud. So now if you look into that hole in the wall, which is a life upgrade, you see that the area is not loaded. You did nothing wrong, no worries. The loading trigger for the life upgrade, and more importantly, the upper half of the courtyard is at this hole. So you go to the ladder, or you just have to be close to the ladder, as can be seen here. You can just walk up to the edge and then walk back. So now there are two possibilities. Either the life upgrade area is loaded, then you did everything correctly, or it is not loaded, which means you either misaimed your zip into courtyard, or you didn't hit the trigger at the ladder, or you completely forgot to hit the loading trigger at the ladder. Most likely you misaimed your zip. And that's all for this episode. We talked about three quite easy zips and a bit of movement, and next time we'll proceed until after the dead fight.